You're good.
Taking courses in college and then bring up an extra school. So Reader's Theater is important because, you know, it shows that it can improve reading fluency along with word choice and comprehension. And then I did mine on where the wild things are. So I would do mine for about, I would say, like, third grade. You know, you can introduce the book at any time, but I would focus more on the message of the book by the animation and stuff. So I need six. And then I made those little story cards. These would just be, they wouldn't be like puppets or anything. They would just be some cards, like the student proverbs that they are.
I know. Teacher's not here. I'm volunteering.
Yeah, it rocks. It was mine. Great. It was a gunshot in the grill.
Where?
Gunshot in the grill. The guy from the east.
It's so cute.
We never caught him. That's scary.
Okay. Circle.
And I chose a new spirit for
which prehistoria began as far back as the 15th century in Greece. And I was explaining to my daughter, sometimes you would see the old Roman movies, and they have the people standing up in the museum, that was as far back as how the Greek theater had began. And I also found research that some people had done on the Reader's Theater can be used anywhere from kindergarten all the way up to high school. And it also showed that they had done Reader's Theater with some high school students. And the high school students grade reading the whole book within 7 months faster than they had within a year. So they increased their reading level within 7 months rather than a year. So I thought that was really interesting because it allowed the children to stand up and able to read without being afraid. Reader's Theater, like they said before, it doesn't really have props, but you can use props. But most of the time, when it's used, from what I've researched, it's usually the teacher will give the students a book and they will give them a character and they can read it. However, they also will allow the children to practice the reading before they stand up to read. So it causes repetition, which helps them to read better. I chose Reader's Theater because in the lesson that I will have for next week, I'll be using it to teach multiplication. And I also found some books at the Wayne State Library. This is math and literature, which helps children to understand what it is. This one's called math.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, I shall do my greatest.
No.
So I too created a club puppet. And I'm here.
So basically, the National Storytelling
it was stated in our research that people don't understand the value of storytelling. With a lot of different other human expressions, for instance, if you were in theater, they put up, actors put up what they call the fourth wall. And the fourth wall is basically you on stage and you don't see your audience, or you treat your audience as if they're not there. And the audience is somewhat like the flying wall, is what they call it. You know, where there's no interaction between the storyteller and the listener, the reader and the listener. There is. So that's what makes storytelling unique, because you have the audience and you have the listener, which is the audience, and yourself, which is the reader. You guys interact with each other. And when you are telling stories, the imagination and all those things kind of come to life. With storytelling, there's different types of things that are used. We have nonverbal communication, body language, gesture, sign language. The spoken word is also another form of storytelling. And so today, like I said, there was so much. I just was like, what I decided to do, I found a short story that talked about the long vowel sound. And so, I also noticed, and I don't know if it's okay to do, but to like maybe change some of the verbiage so that when you're reading, you might be able to connect with your audience. So I did a little change in my life. So bear with me. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to pass out the long vowel sound. So what would happen, just for me to have my audience involved. When I point to you, you're going to say a letter. And it's just so that the student can get used to hearing this long vowel. Because I don't know about you, but when I was growing up, I didn't realize, as you teach, you learn more, opposed to when you are actually the student. And being teaching the kindergarten is the short and long vowel. When I started, I'm like, oh my God, this is so easy. Because when you're trying to decode words, it's hard to decode short and long vowel sounds. You know. So of course, I would also, introduce. We would have already talked about the vowels. We know that the A says its name. This is how I explain it. The A says its name. What is the A name? What is E's name? What is I's name? What is O's name? And what is U's name?
U.
Very important. So the short vowel says the sound of your name. And so that's what then they go around and they say the sound of their name. So the A sound, your name sounds what? Like? Yeah. A. E. A.
Oh,
I'm sorry. And see, you much A and I sound so much alike that you have to have a really good listening ear to be able to just decide which one is which. I also play with games with my kids when I teach them games. That is, this is a, e, I, a, e, I, a. So we sing the song.
Yeah. Okay.
Yes, I like the song.
A goes, B goes. Goes, I, P goes, goes, T goes like a clock. U goes up. B goes boom. Back and tail. What's next? W goes whoa. I'm washing machine. X, which is hard because you never, you know, tell me. I did not understand the X sound until I started working. It's the K and the S.
Yeah.
And then Y is a hard one, so we can jump for your job. And then Z, and it's really strange how the kids sometimes they don't remember the sound. If I do a motion, they'll be able to tell me the sound.
Right.
So, you know. Well,
obviously, your student from last year.
Okay, so my story is the short story. I-E-I-A-E-I-O-U. Okay? It was summer, a long, hot, dry summer. And the balls lounged around everyone when they ever get any exercise. Of course, I would have memorized this story. I wouldn't have to use it. Because there hasn't been enough rain to give them the lift they needed to get going. Oh! Where are you?
Oh, okay.
What did you say? I just said you.
Oh. Recorded.